Hey bookworms, it's Jade from Bedtime Bookworm and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to tell you about some of my anticipated releases for the winter. These are some of my favorite videos to do. I love doing the research to see what books are coming up and deciding on which ones I am excited about. As a reminder, this is not a TBR. These are not necessarily books that I'm going to be picking up anytime soon. These are books that are coming out in the months of December, January, and February. They're ones that I'm interested in and kind of want to keep an eye out and see what people say about them once they do come out. Some of these I might read sooner than others, but in general, I don't read a lot of new releases. I kind of prefer the wait and see approach and kind of see which of these continue to be buzzy after they've been out for a while. If you want to know what I'm planning to read in the winter, then watch my winter TBR video, which should be coming out in a couple of weeks. Also, I didn't put any books on this list that are sequels to series that I am not reading. There are definitely a lot of series that I have my eye on and want to read one day that have sequels coming out, but I didn't want to include them on my list because if I included those, I would have way too many to talk about. I was able to narrow this list down to 15 books, with like half of them coming out in February. The winter definitely tends to be a lighter book release season, especially in December and January. This list is a bit of a mix between YA and adult, and it does contain a few different genres, but the majority of the books that I'm going to talk about in this video are going to be fantasy and probably YA fantasy. All right, I've got 15 books to talk to you about that are coming out in the next 3 months. The first book on my list is coming out on December 3rd, and that is Children of Virtue and Vengeance, which is the second book in the Legacy of Orisha series by Tomi Adeyemi. I did read the first book in the series right when it came out, which at this point has been almost 2 years, so the details on that one have definitely gotten a little bit rusty. The series is a YA high fantasy that is African inspired. I do remember that I thought the magic system in the series was really interesting, but I thought the first book was a little tropey and I didn't like some of the decisions that the author had made, but I was still intrigued enough that I wanted to continue on in the series. At this point, I'm not sure if I'm going to pick this one up right away or if I want to wait for the series to be completely finished and kind of go back to the beginning so I can binge them, because there was at least a year and a half between the release of the first two books. And if there's going to be another like year and a half, 2 years until the third book, then maybe I should just wait and read them all at once when it's done. Even though I don't know if I'm going to pick it up soon, I'm excited that it is finally coming out, and I know a lot of other people are looking forward to this one too. The next book on my list is also coming out on December 3rd, and that is Dead Astronauts by Jeff Vandermeer. I put this book on my list because of the author, Jeff Vandermeer. He is the author of Annihilation as well as Born, which both fall into the weird sci-fi category. I haven't read either of them and I don't really know if weird sci-fi is my thing, but I'm very intrigued by the idea. I didn't realize this at first, but this book is set in the same world as Born and is listed as a sequel on Goodreads, but I'm not sure if it's just like more of a companion book and just happens to be set in the same world or not. Either way, I bet this will be a pretty buzzy book and I'm excited to see how it's received. The next book on my list is The Dead Girls Club by Damian Angelica Waters. This is an adult supernatural thriller. The first little bit of the blurb says, a supernatural thriller in the vein of A Head Full of Ghosts about two young girls, a scary story that becomes far too real, and the tragic and terrifying consequences that follow them into adulthood. I have never read any Damian Angelica Waters before, but my friend Rachel from The Shades of Orange really enjoyed her short story collection and also enjoyed this book, and she really loves this author, so I'm excited about this book coming out and I might give it a try to see what I think, although I am considering starting with her short story collection. Those are the only books on my list in December. December is a pretty light month on book releases because of the holidays. The next book on my list is coming out on January 7th of 2020. I can't believe it's about to be 2020. And that book is Lady Hotspur by Tessa Grattan, which is an adult fantasy book. I have not read any Tessa Grattan before, but I've heard a lot about her books, particularly The Queens of Innes Lear. And I believe that this book is set in the same world as The Queens of Innes Lear, but I'm not entirely sure. And they're not like listed as a series on Goodreads or anything. Oh yeah, there's this in the blurb. It says, inspired by Shakespeare's Henry IV, Lady Hotspur continues the saga of Innisfliers centuries later as revolution, love, and a betrayal corrupt the descendants of two warring kingdoms. I do kind of want to read The Queens of Innisfliers first, but I am really excited that Tessa Grattan has another book coming out and is set in the same world because I've heard so many good things about The Queens of Innisfliers. And I'm also very intrigued by the inspired by Shakespeare thing. The next book on my list is Nameless Queen by Rachel McLaughlin. This is also coming out on January 7th. This is a YA high fantasy, and the first couple of lines of the blurb really caught my eye. It says, one girl must make a name for herself or die trying in this royal fantasy where an unknown peasant becomes the ultimate ruler. But how long can she keep the crown for herself if everyone wants her dead? Perfect for fans of Furyborn, Red Queen, and Everless. And out of those three, I've only read Red Queen, which I enjoyed, but I haven't finished the series yet. And Furyborn is definitely on my TBR. I really want to read it. This one just kind of sounds fun, and it's currently listed on Goodreads as a standalone. So obviously that caught my eye. As someone who was constantly trying not to start new series, it makes me really happy to see a YA fantasy standalone. The next book on my list is Dark and Deepest Red by Anna Marie McLemore, which is coming out on January 14th. I have yet to read an Anna Marie McLemore book, but I've heard so many good things about all of her books, so I was really excited to see another one of her books coming out. They're all standalone, so I don't know why I haven't picked one up yet. But I think all of her books are magical realism with like LGBT themes, and I think also like Hispanic heritage themes, but I could be wrong about that. The end of this blurb says, with McLemore's signature lush prose, which I've heard so much about, Dark and Deepest Red pairs the forbidding magic of a fairy tale with a modern story of passion and betrayal. I also think that the cover for this book is one of the prettiest ones I've seen. Next on my list is Ash Lords by Scott Rankin. This is coming out on January 21st and is a YA fantasy book. This one caught my eye because of the author Scott Rankin. He wrote the Nixia series, which is a sci-fi series that I haven't read yet, but I have heard a lot of buzz about and it's on my TBR. I'm definitely interested in reading that one. So the name of the author caught my eye, but then once I clicked on it and heard what it was kind of about, I was even more excited about it. The beginning of the blurb says, Red Rising meets the Scorpio races in this epic fantasy following three phoenix horse riders skilled at alchemy who must compete at the races, the modern spectacle that has replaced warfare within their empire. So just like the beginning of Red Rising meets the Scorpio races, had my ears perked. I have read The Scorpio Races by Maggie Stiefvater and I really enjoyed it. I haven't read Red Rising, but that is definitely on my TBR. That's actually a series that I'm hoping to tackle in 2020. And the idea of like phoenix horse riders in a deadly race sounds so much fun and I'm definitely interested in this one. The next one on my list is the one that I am probably the most excited about out of everything else on this list. And that is This Vicious Cure by Emily Suveda. This is the third and final book in the This Mortal Coil series, which is a YA sci-fi dystopian series that I have been so in love with ever since I read the first book. This is set in a world where people have control panels set into their arms where they can hack their own DNA and change things about their bodies in some really cool and fascinating ways. On top of that, it's post-apocalyptic because it's set after there's been a disease outbreak of a really weird virus, one that I describe as being like a backwards zombie virus. The virus in this world is one of the coolest ones that I've ever read, and it's one of the things that I love about this series. The first two books were totally action-packed, had me on the edge of my seat. I had so much fun while reading them, and I expect no less from this last book. And that takes us into February. The next book on my list is The Stars We Steal by Alexa Dunn, which is coming out on February 4th. Alexa Dunn is a authortuber here on YouTube, and I have been following her channel for quite a while. I really enjoy watching her writing videos as well as her book videos because she does do like wrap-ups and things on her channel. This is Alexa Dunn's second book. I haven't read her first one, but they are both YA science fiction books that are inspired by or retellings of other books. So this one she has pitched as Jane Austen meets The Bachelor in Space, which I'm not really a fan of either of those things. Jane Austen, just because I haven't read it, but definitely not a huge fan of the show The Bachelor. But I'm still really interested to see what people are going to think about this book when it comes out, and I do think it's a promise that will appeal to a lot of readers. Next, I have The Queen's Assassin by Melissa De La Cruz, which is coming out on February 4th. Looks like this is going to be the first book in a series, so I probably realistically won't be picking this one up, but it caught my eye when I saw the author's name. I've heard of Melissa De La Cruz before, but I haven't read any of her books, but I don't believe that fantasy is her usual genre, so I'm always interested in seeing how people do when they go into a new genre, especially when they're coming into fantasy from something else, because I love fantasy so much. The first bit of the blurb says, "Perfect for fans of Sarah J. Maas and Red Queen," which I'm not a huge Sarah J. Maas fan. "This is the first novel in a sweeping YA fantasy romance duet about a deadly assassin, his mysterious apprentice, and the country they are sworn to protect," from the New York Times bestselling author Melissa De La Cruz. I love me a good assassin story, and only time will tell if this is a good assassin story. The next one is also coming out on February 4th, and that is Below by Alexandria Warwick. This is the first book in a series called North. Again, because it's the first book in a series, I don't know if I'll actually be picking this up soon, but the premise of this was really interesting. This is being pitched as a YA dark fantasy series that is inspired by Inuit mythology, which is so cool. In this world, there is a demon named Face Stealer, and a girl has to go on a journey to find her sister's face. And that just sounds fascinating. Next, I have Untamed Shore by Silvia Moreno Garcia, which is coming out on February 11th. This is another one that made it on my list because of the author. I have heard so much about Silvia Moreno Garcia before, but I haven't read any of her books. This is an adult suspense or thriller book that is also a coming-of-age story set in Mexico. It does seem like this is a new genre for her to be breaking into, but I've heard so many good things about this author that I'm excited to see if people are gonna love this one as much as they love her other books. Next, I have The Unspoken Name by A.K. Larkwood, which is the first book in the Serpent Gates series. This is also coming out on February 11th, and it's an adult high fantasy. It looks like it's about a girl or a woman who her whole life she has known she is destined to be the sacrifice and has to give up her life at the Shrine of the Unspoken. But on the day of her foretold death, a powerful mage offers her a new fate, to turn away from her destiny and her god, to become a thief, a spy, an assassin, a wizard's loyal sword. I just think that sounds really interesting, and I absolutely love the cover of this book as well. It is the first book in a series, so I'm not sure if I'm gonna start it anytime soon, but I hope a lot of other people read it so I can see what they think about it and put it on my list of series that I wanna read. Next, I have The Glass Hotel by Emily St. John Mandel. This is coming out on February 15th. This is not really my genre. It is going to be an adult literary fiction book, but I put it on the list because of the author, Emily St. John Mandel. This is the author of Station 11, which I read a couple of years ago, and while the ending was a little disappointing, I still really enjoyed that book. It was kind of literary, but it was also post-apocalyptic, so it was a little more in my wheelhouse than this one sounds like it's going to be. Still, I'm willing to give anything by this author a try, and I'm sure that a lot of other people are excited for her to be coming out with a new book, because it's been a while since she's released something. And then the last book on my list is Red Hood by Lana K. Arnold, which is coming out on February 25th. This is a YA fantasy, and it's a Little Red Riding Hood retelling, which immediately caught my eye. I love retellings, and I haven't seen Little Red Riding Hood done very often. I have attempted to read one retelling of Little Red Riding Hood before, and I DNF'd it, so that one didn't go so well. So I was excited to see another one coming out that I might give a try. And it does look like this is a standalone, so I might actually pick this up next year. The end of the blurb says, "Alana K. Arnold, National Book Award finalist and author of Prince Honor book Damsel, returns with a dark, engrossing, blood-drenched tale of the familiar threats to female power and one girl's journey to regain it." Alright guys, those are 15 books that are coming out in the next 3 months that I am looking forward to and wanting to keep my eye on. Let me know what other books are coming out in the next 3 months that you guys are excited about. I know there are quite a few sequels to series coming out that a lot of people are excited about, but they just happen to be series that I'm not currently reading, even if they are series that I want to be reading. So I didn't include those on my list. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you like bookish content. That is all I have for now. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, bookworms, keep reading. Bye.